I know that your town, your roots and your family have played a great role in your life. You were born in Gdańsk in 1957.
Yeah, it's true. And Gdańsk is really unique, not only for me, I think, but for the whole history of Europe, of region, of Poland, because, you know, you can find still today influences of many cultures, religions, languages, Polish culture, German, Swedish, Jewish, Scottish, and of course Kashubian. In fact, I am Kashubian also, not only a citizen of Gdańsk, but also Kashubian. It means, you know, that I am part of the ethnic minority. It's about 300,000 people with their own language, with their own customs, very traditional, very loyal to their tradition, to religion. And if you want to know everything about Europe, you can learn something about Gdańsk, and it would be enough, I think. My four identities, because I am from Gdańsk, because I am a Kashubian, I am a Pole, it's my main identity, of course, and I am a European. Yeah, this is what I am very proud of, you know, because it's this is a foundation of this modern thinking and modern feeling about Europe.
And your parents?
Yeah, my parents. You know, my father was a carpenter. He died when I was 14. He was a very strict father and strong person, if you know what I mean. And my mother was pure goodness and pure love. She was a really beautiful woman. Simple, but very wise. And of course, she worked very hard to support me and my sister after my father died. My older sister took care that I didn't become a hooligan, you know, because in fact I spent my whole life in this time on the streets and among hooligans, football fans. Yeah, no, we lived in poverty, but in happy and loving family.
As I know, history, in particular the history of ancient Greece, is your real passion.
Yeah, it's true, but history around me was much more interesting than books. It was in 1970 when blood riots erupted right under my windows. It was a huge protest against communist regime. Thousands of people took to the streets. I saw policemen shooting at workers. Dozens were killed. I saw public buildings on fire, tanks, blood. And from the very beginning, it was clear for me, even though I was, you know, a teenager, who is on the right side and who is on the wrong side. And from this time, you know, still today, I know that people who are beaten are much more often right than people who beat them.
This was your first experience with politics as a very young man. And when did you start your adventure with politics in a serious way?
I was a student. I started my studies at Gdańsk University in 1976. Of course, I read history. And I engaged in, you know, something like illegal activities in so-called democratic opposition. It was a small group of students. We cooperated with other groups of workers, also very small. It was in 1979, I think, when I met Lech Wałęsa. We had no idea that our very few small groups would change into 10 million people movement, national movement, in fact. I mean, of course, the solidarity. It was after our great strike in August, in 1980. Then I started my regular job as a journalist in one of two newspapers of solidarity movement. I established Independent Students Association. It was, in fact, a part of the student part of solidarity. And yes, but this the whole Solidarity Carnival was, as you know, interrupted by General Jaruzelski and his army in the end of 1981.
Yes, with the imposition of martial law.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Martial law was a dramatic time for Poles, but I guess it was also very dramatic for you personally.
Yeah, you know, it was a really difficult time for all of members of Solidarity. Thousands of people were arrested. Thousands of people went into hiding. I lost my job, like Gosia, my wife, because she was also an activist of Solidarity. We lost our flat. I was hiding for a short time to avoid being arrested. But, you know, in fact, I am really lucky devil. Because when they arrested me in 1983, after a few days, General Jaruzelski announced the amnesty for the political prisoners, and I was free. But I had to start with completely new profession. I worked as a bread seller for 1 year, and then I started with something completely new. I became a manual worker, working on high altitudes, you know, on chimneys in factories, on high constructions, installations, and we painted and rebuilt these chimneys with the use of climbing equipment, you know, almost 7 years on rope, like crazy alpinist. Exciting time. At the same time, of course, we were engaged in the political underground. I established a monthly, illegal monthly, propagating new ideas, new in the Polish reality. I mean, principles of liberal democracy, rules of free market, this pro-European orientations in politics. Yeah, it was really something new also in the Solidarity movement. And around this monthly centered some people, interesting young people, economists, experts also from my university. And, you know, we had no idea that we established, in fact, something like think tank. But yeah, it was one of the first in Polish history. We worked for Lech Wałęsa, then the leader of illegal Solidarity movement. And this is why after the collapse of communism, after 1989, our group formed, in fact, the first liberal government in Poland after the first free presidential election in Poland, when Lech Wałęsa became president. He supported us in this new challenge, I mean new government.
What were you responsible for?
You know, our circle called Gdańsk Liberals established a new political party, Liberal Democratic Congress, and I became its leader. But in administration, I was responsible for privatizing and demonopolization of former communistic state-owned press concern and printing houses. Very exciting and also demanding work, but for sure useful, and it was interesting time.
I know that you never gave up altogether on your passion for history.
Yeah, you know, especially after my first defeat as a party leader in the next election, it was in 1993. From this time, I was on the margin of Polish politics, maybe for 4 or 5 years. But it was a wonderful time in my life because I returned to my passion as a historian and as a journalist. I wrote some books about history of Gdańsk, and some of them became bestsellers. I have to acknowledge that the satisfaction as an author was much bigger than as a political leader or party leader, especially that you know Then my successes as a political leader were a little bit ambiguous, in fact. But of course I returned to politics. It was in 1997, and then I won the election as a candidate to Senate, and I became deputy speaker of this house.
So the greatest political story of your life was just about to begin.
Yeah, you're right, I think. It was in 2001 when we started with a new political formation, civic platform. It was something like, you know, protest against routine and corruption in politics. And for people, the civic platform was like promise of something like fresh air in our political reality. But it was also a risky step, and the beginnings were difficult. In the end, it was in 2007, we won the election after a very tough and brutal campaign, and I became prime minister. I'm a modest person, but I think I can say that it was successful two terms, especially the condition of Polish economy. It's unbelievable that the Polish economy grew by 20%, and while European economy was about zero at the same time. And it's really impressive, and it's not a coincidence, you know. I have also, you know, my personal satisfaction, because I was the first prime minister in Poland who was elected two times, and 7 years, it was the longest term in the whole history of democratic Poland. Also very important was for me the reputation of Poland. I think about relationship with neighbors, and today I can say that after the 7 years, Poland is in the heart of Europe. It's one of the pillars of European Union, not a troublemaker from peripheries. And this is, I think, very significant difference. Yeah, I am proud.
Now, as president of the European Council, you face new challenges.
Yes, it's something different, of course, and something new for me. But, you know, I am optimist. Because maybe all what Europe needs today, it's, you know, energy, optimism, engagement, faith, and this is my specialization. Of course, I am not a naive person. You know, after being for 7 years prime minister in Poland, I can't be naive. And for sure, we have to do with some new challenges and some troubles, especially that the condition of Europe, inside Europe, it's not so good as 10 or 20 years ago. As you know, some people in Europe are questioning our fundamental values like freedom. The peace is threatened because of very difficult situation in our neighborhoods in the east and in the south. We are, you know, before the absolutely crucial decision about so-called TTIP, I mean, this trade agreement with the USA, what is absolutely fundamental for our transatlantic relationship. And for me, this transatlantic community, it's like a synonym of Western civilization. And yeah, this is the most important challenge, not only for me, for us, to save our civilization, because we know that that there are some problems, some troubles, and some enemies. But, you know, I am energetic enough and optimistic enough, and I deeply believe in Europe. What is, I think today, this is maybe the most important thing.
And what is your greatest ambition?
You know, I think that my greatest ambition is to teach my two grandsons to play football. Because, you know, football is my passion, and family is my passion. My wonderful wife, my wonderful daughter and daughter-in-law, my brave and intelligent son, and of course, Mateusz and Mikołaj, two devils, you know. I mean my grandsons. Yeah, family is my greatest happiness.